The sky is seeing Jesus someday, sometime in the sky. See Jesus someday, sometime in the sky. Holy Spirit of the Most High God, the Spirit of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, we worship you. We honor you, we give you all the praises, for there is no one like you. You are our senior partner, that I cannot do without you. I ask that you use me again as your microphone. Speak your word to your world. I am so confident, oh God, there will be salvation of souls. Healing with that place, miraculous things will happen. And Jesus Christ will be glorified in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Father. Welcome to the moment of good news. Welcome to the moment of good news. Jesus Christ loves you so much. And his mercies are new every morning. His mercies are new every day. Oh, thank you, Ancient of Days. Oh, thank you, Jesus Christ. Thank you for the love you have for man. Thank you for the love you have for the whole world. We give you all the praises. We give you all the honor in the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Father. Be thou exalted, Lord. I know you will live with the Lord Jesus Christ forever. Thank you, Father. You will live with the Lord Jesus Christ forever. Thank you, Father. I'll be speaking on what I titled, The Endless Relationship. The Endless Relationship. And I know that you will enjoy this wonderful message in the name of Jesus Christ. The Endless Relationship. Oh, you will live with the Lord Jesus Christ forever. I say you will live with the Lord Jesus Christ forever. It's not about your religion. It's not about what you are now, who you are now. It's about what Jesus Christ will do in your life now. And I know that you will live with the Lord Jesus Christ forever. Thank you, Ancient of Days. In Jesus' name, you see, the plan of God is for you and I to spend eternity with him in heaven. God's plan is for you and I to spend eternity with him in heaven. Praise God. Eternity is more than 1 billion years. Eternity is more than 10 billion years. Eternity is more than 3 trillion years. Eternity is forever and ever. And God's plan is that you will spend eternity with him in heaven. Praise God. You see, eternity is forever and ever. There is hell and there's also heaven. Hell is not your portion. You cannot spend eternity in hell. You cannot live in hell forever. You cannot enter hell. I speak to you in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. The hell or hellfire is not your portion. Heaven is your portion. God's plan is that you will spend eternity in heaven. More than billions of years. That is your portion in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. Don't forget this. Hell is worse than the sorrows of this world. And I said that hell is not your portion in the name of Jesus Christ. God loves you so much. He wants you to spend eternity with him in heaven. That's good news. Good news. God loves you so much. He wants you to spend eternity with him in heaven. And I know that this will not elude you. It will not elude your family members. It will not elude your loved ones in the name of Jesus. God has said it. It is possible. Now look at the scripture, John chapter 3 and verse 16. Praise God. John 3 verse 16. For God so loved the world that he gave his one and only son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish but have eternal life. Now let me paraphrase. God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever believes in him will not go to hell. Hellfire will not be your portion. Instead, you will go to heaven. Heaven will be your portion, and you will spend eternity in heaven forever and ever. Now look at that. Praise God. Take creation of days. Oh, we will be with the Lord Jesus Christ forever. That is endless relationship in heaven. Now you see verse 17 of John chapter 3, for God did not send his son into the world to condemn the world, but to save the world through him. Praise God. Now see verse 18, whoever believes in him is not condemned. Whoever believes in him will not go to hell. Praise God. But whoever does not believe stands condemned already, because he has not believed in the name of God's one and only Son. Praise God. God loves you so much. He sent his only Son so that anyone that believes in him will not go to hell. Remember Numbers 23 and verse 19. God is not a man, he cannot lie. He is not a man, he cannot deceive. He is not a man, he cannot change. He has said, anyone that believes in Jesus Christ will never go to hell. And I am sure you are believing, your loved ones are believing, you will not go to hell, you will enjoy heaven. And I know that you'll be excited in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Thank you, Father. Again, in John chapter 14 and verse 1. John 14 and verse 1, Jesus Christ says, do not let your hearts be troubled. Trust in God, trust also in me. Oh, verse 2 says, in my Father's house are many rooms, are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you, I am going there to prepare a place for you. Verse 3, and if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come back. And take you to be with me, that you also may be where I am. Praise God. Thank you, Father. Oh, to be with the Lord Jesus Christ forever. We will be with the Lord forever. That is endless relationship. Endless relationship. Jesus Christ is Lord. He is God. He is Yahweh. And he cannot lie. He says, I am coming back. I am coming back for you. I will come back and take you to be with me, that you also may be where I am. Good news. I know that God will never disappoint you. He has said it. He is coming back for you, for the believers, and you will spend eternity with him forever and ever in heaven. Thank you, Father. Again, in 1 Thessalonians chapter 4 and verse 16, 1 Thessalonians chapter 4 and verse 16, for the Lord himself will come down from heaven. That is the scripture. From heaven with a loud command, with the voice of the archangel, and with the trumpet call of God, and the dead in Christ shall rise first. Verse 17 says, After that, we who are still alive and are left, we be caught, praise God, we be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air. To meet the Lord in the air. Now look at the last sentence here. And so we will be with the Lord forever. We will be with the Lord forever. Praise God. That is endless relationship. We will be with the Lord forever. You see, God cannot lie. God cannot change. He says, we will be with him forever. Endless relationship. He's so excited. The one that loves you so passionately. And he's the one that created heavens and earth. All things are possible with him. He says, you will be with him forever. That is endless relationship. You will not be with the devil. You will be with the Lord Jesus Christ, the Alpha and the Omega, the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords, the one that created all the things you are seeing, the one that created all the beautiful things you are seeing in the world. He says, you will be with him forever. I am so excited. I am so happy. It's so interesting that you and I will be with the Lord forever and ever. And I know that nothing will stop you, nothing will stop your loved ones in the name of Jesus. That is endless relationship. Endless relationship. You will be with the Lord forever. Praise God. Thank you, Father. Again, that John 3 and verse 18, the Bible says, whoever believes in him is not condemned. But whoever does not believe stands condemned already, because he has not believed in the name of God's one and only Son. Anyone that says no to Jesus Christ, anyone that rejects Jesus Christ, anyone that says he's not the Lord, is condemned already. That is the scripture. That is the word of God. Look at that. Look at it again. Oh, thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Whoever believes in him is not condemned. But whoever does not believe stands condemned already, because he has not believed in the name of God's one and only Son. What does that tell you? There shall be eternal separation. There shall be eternal separation. The ones that say no to Jesus Christ will not be in heaven with you. You will be in heaven because you believe Jesus Christ. He is your Lord and Savior. But there are many millions of people, billions of people that have said no, who have said no to Jesus Christ. And the Bible says that they are condemned. And for the fact that they are condemned, they are going to hell. That's what the Bible says. I know you will not be happy that you'll be in heaven and your friends and relatives will be in hell. That is eternal separation. Remember, it's endless thing. It's forever and ever. You will be in heaven while your friends and loved ones will be in hell. God forbid. Praise God. Thank you, Ancient of Days. I know you want to spend eternity with your loved ones. Everyone wants to spend eternity with their loved ones, with their family members, with their friends, with their neighbors. You want to spend eternity in heaven with them. And I know that it is possible. The Lord will help you and you will do something about that. Oh, tomorrow may be too late. Thank you, Ancient of Days. Now look at this. Look at this. Number one, when your child or a relative goes to a boarding school just to study, you will cry because to you, you will not see him or her for a while. You will miss him. Your child, your brother is going to school or boarding school. You will cry because you will not see him for a while. Praise God. Just for 3 months, you are crying. Your son is leaving you. He's going to school. He wants to leave his school. He wants to be a brother. You are crying because you will not see him for a while. Number two, when your loved one travels to a long distance country, you cry again because you will not see him or her for a while. Let's say you are in Nigeria and your loved one is traveling to America. You will cry because you will not see him for a while. That is separation. Now, the third one, when your loved one dies, you cry. You know, death is inevitable. Death is inevitable. So when your loved one dies, you cry very well because of the fact that you will not see him or her again. You cry because you will not see your loved one again. Praise God. Now, how much more the eternal separation? Where you will be in heaven forever and your loved ones will be in hell forever. That is eternal separation. And that will not be a portion in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Oh, you are in heaven and your loved ones and relatives are in hell. That will not be a portion. It will not be a portion in the name of Jesus. You want to be in heaven. You want to spend eternity in heaven with your loved ones. That is endless relationship. The same way Jesus Christ wants to spend eternity with you, that's how you will want to spend eternity with your loved ones in heaven, in a better place. And I know that heaven is a better place. Hell is not your portion in the name of Jesus Christ. You can't even forgive yourself. There are things you can do now to ensure that your loved ones spend eternity with you in heaven. If you don't do it now, you will not be able to enjoy all the things you need to enjoy in heaven. Oh, praise God. You can't regret in heaven. The time is now. You got to do something. You must do something to ensure that there is no eternal separation. You will enjoy this endless relationship. Oh, that your friend, you love him so much. You love her so much. That your brother, you love him so much. You love her so much. You want to spend with him or her all the time. You love your parents. You want to spend time with them. This is the time to talk to them. It's the time to pray to them. It's the time to prepare them so that all of us will be in heaven forever. Praise God. Thank you, Ancient of Days. Now, what must I do in order to spend eternity in heaven with all my relatives and loved ones? What must I do? Today is the day. This is the period. Tomorrow may be too late. Tomorrow may be too late. You can do something now. Number one, pray for them. Pray for them. No one comes to God except it draws. The prayer for them will help them. God will answer your prayers. God answers our prayers. Pray for them. Say, oh God, I want my brother, I want my sister to accept Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior. God answers prayers. He will answer your prayers because you are praying in accordance with the will of God. God does not want anyone to perish. As you pray for your loved ones, God will answer. Number two, preach to them. Preach to them. Preach to them. Share the good news with them. Preach to them. Let them understand that eternity is real. That after this world, there's another place where we will spend eternity. Preach to them and tell them that Jesus Christ is the only way. In accordance with John chapter 14 and verse 6, Jesus says, I am the only way. It's not about your religion. It's about Jesus Christ, the only way to heaven. Tell them about Jesus Christ. Pray to them, pray to them, pray to them. Even if they say no today, pray to them again. Keep on preaching to them. Keep on praying for them. Pray to them. God will do something. Even as I am preaching now, as you share this, your friends will hear it. As you share this, as you click like, your friends will hear it. Pray to them, pray to your friends, pray to your ladies, and I know that God will talk about. Number three, lead them to Christ. If they are willing, the moment they believe, lead them to Christ. Don't wait. Lead them to Christ immediately. The fourth one, help them to be established in a Bible believing church. Help them, encourage them to be established in a Bible believing church where they will learn, where they will study the scriptures, and as they study the scripture, they will grow spiritually and their faith will increase. If that person is not born again, as he or she hears the word of God, he will believe and he will surrender. He will accept Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior. There are things you must do now. Do these four things. Believe me, you will never regret in heaven. You will not be angry that your friends and relatives are in hell while you are in heaven. And I know that you will enjoy endless relationship in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. All things are possible. Now, tomorrow may be too late. Thank you, Ancient of Days. Before I pray for you, before I pray for those who want to accept Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior, let me show you the scripture. Romans chapter 10, Romans chapter 10 and from verse 8 to 11. But what does it say? What does it say? The word is near you. It is in your mouth and in your heart. Praise God. Thank you, Father. That is the word of faith we are preaching. The word of faith that we are preaching. Praise God. Verse 9 says that if you confess with your mouth Jesus is Lord and believe in your heart that God raised him from the dead, you will be saved. You can tell them all this as I'm speaking to you right now is the truth and nothing but the truth. Oh, thank you, Father. Verse 10 says, for it is with your heart that you believe and are justified. Thank you, Father. And it is with your mouth that you confess and are saved. Praise God. You tell them all this as I am speaking to you right now. Romans 10 verse 11 says, as the scripture says, anyone who trusts, anyone who believes in him will never be disappointed, will not be put to shame. Thank you, Ancient of Days. That is the word of God. It's the word of life. The word that changes lives. The word that gives eternal life. Father, give you praises. I know that someone wants to accept Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior. You have believed. You want to declare it now. You don't want eternal separation. You want an endless relationship. And that is your portion in the name of Jesus Christ. Let me pray for you. It's not about your religion. It's about Jesus Christ, the only true God, the way to heaven. Oh, say after me, say, Lord Jesus Christ, I have heard your word. I believe with all my heart that you are the Son of the living God. I believe that you died for my sin. I believe that you were buried. Oh, on the third day you rose from the dead. Oh, Lord Jesus Christ, I declare as I have believed, you are my Lord and my Savior. Thank you for dying for me. Thank you for the power to live a rapturable life. I give you all the praises in Jesus' name. If you have prayed this prayer, congratulations, you are born again. You will enjoy heaven with the Lord Jesus Christ, and that will be your portion in the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Ancient of Days. In Jesus' name, I pray for you. Father, I release blessings unto your children in the name of Jesus Christ. The blessings of today will not elude you. The spiritual blessings, financial blessings, material blessings, all things are yours. All things are yours. You are healed in the name of Jesus. Receive your healing now. Receive your healing now. The blood of Jesus Christ is flowing. It's working for you, destroying the virus, destroying the power of sickness, destroying the bacterium, destroying the fungus. Receive your healing now. Receive your healing now in the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Ancient of Days, in Jesus' name. Thank you, Father, for all the things you have done. Oh, by God's grace, I am Pastor Chidi Onyesong, the gatekeeper, Saving Ark Christian Ministries. We are in Arab Road, at number 10, Arab Road, Kubwa Abuja. You are blessed and you are rapturable. Jesus Christ loves you. Thank you, Ancient of Days. I encourage you to share this. Oh, like it so that your friends will benefit from this message. There will not be eternal separation. You will enjoy endless relationship with the Lord Jesus Christ and your loved ones. Praise God. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Jesus.